everybody. Welcome to the Northern Ireland Science Festival 2021. And I am Scientific Sue, and we are going to be looking at some magic. Oops, let's try that one again. And we are going to look at some magic. I love these ones, but as you've seen, it takes a little bit of practice to be able to use them. And it's made from a very amazing material that remembers its shape. So I'm going to wind this one up again, and then I can keep it safe with a little elastic band until I want to do my magic again. And we need to do this 3 times. So over the week, I'm going to be looking at 3 spells. Today's spell is going to be the GLACIUS spell. GLACIUS because it's very cold. And so let's try that again. Abra! The best part of all of what we're going to do is practice, practice, practice makes perfect. Let's take this hat off anyway. I've got ice here. And over time, we've had lots of scientists that have been experimenting with temperature. But they could only experiment in the wintertime because we didn't have electricity, we didn't have refrigerators. So as soon as the spring came, they then had to stop all of those experiments. And 2 scientists, one called Fahrenheit and one called Celsius. Both of these temperature scales, though, have a negative. So we have a Belfast-born scientist. His name was William Thompson. And then he grew up to become a lord. And then he got knighted, a very, very good scientist. And he was thinking, well, it's silly having a negative. So he decided to look at another way of explaining temperature. Now, we have to think about atoms. Atoms move. But as they get colder, they start to slow down. And then when there's no energy at all, they're stationary. And that's the temperature he called zero. Minus 273 degrees, freezing, really, really cold. And so that temperature scale now is called Kelvin. Now, what I want to do is I want to look at some science that we have on the streets when it's really cold. And a lot of the people in the council will go out with salt and they'll put salt on the roads before it freezes. And the reason for this is this salt, sodium chloride I have here, or we can have calcium chloride, these salt particles are 2 atoms joined together. Just like whenever I rub a balloon on my hair and my hair sticks to the balloon. And we can pull them apart, but we need energy. So we're going to put the salt into this container with the ice and with ice cream mixture. And it's going to use that energy to pull the atoms apart. And as it does that, the temperature will get lower and lower. Now, what I've got here then is a bag, a Ziploc bag. It's got to be very, very tight. And into this, I'm going to put some milk. And we're going to, full fat milk. And we're going to put in some cream. And I love vanilla ice cream. So I am going to put in some vanilla flavoring. Now, you may want to have Nesquik strawberry, vanilla, or chocolate. I think there's a banana one as well. I'm going to put in a little bit of sugar. We don't need sugar with Nesquik. And I'm going to put in my flavoring. This is also a lovely little experiment because it allows us to experiment. What is the perfect amount of milk and cream and sugar and flavorings to make the best ice cream? Air, as we know, because we have it in our woolly jumpers, is a good heat insulator. So we want to make sure we get rid of as much of the air as possible. And then we're going to mix all of that up. And this is at room temperature. And room temperature here is 21 degrees. We're going to put it into the ice, which is at zero. And then I'm going to pour on the salt. And as we do this, we're then going to have the bonds in the salt break, and it's going to take energy out of the system. And we're going to depreciate, lower the temperature. And it's going to go to about minus 16 in about 2 minutes. So I'm going to have to shake this for 2 minutes. Are we ready? And as we do this, we're going to get a change of state. The milk and the cream was liquid. This is a good activity to do outside. It's very noisy. Maybe put some salsa music on. Look, can you see how frosty this looks? We've got ice on the outside here. This is why I'm wearing gloves. Otherwise, I might get frostbite. Let's continue. Even though that felt about 2 minutes, I think it was really only a minute, but let's have a look and investigate and see what we've got inside. Now remember, we have a cup full of salt in here. So when we open up our bag, we're going to have to make sure we keep the salt away from the solid contents. Oh my goodness, we have got ice cream already. What a wonderful glacius spell. I bet you want some, don't you? Well, you're going to have to go to our website, and we have all of the ingredients there in our spell book. And our spell book is going to give you lots and lots of ideas to be able to do your own magic. I think I'm going to have some more of this.
Yummy.
Right. Snow is very cold as well. And snow is also frozen water. So let's move over here and look at some snow. I've got a powder in here. It's called magic snow. We normally just buy this at Christmas time, but we can use this at any time of the year. And I've got another one here that says it's snowballs. And let's investigate with this one here. So what I want to do is I open the bag. I'm keeping it in a nice airtight bag so that it doesn't get wet. So airtight, I can't get into it. There we go. And I'm going to place a small amount of the crystals onto my hand. And this is where you're going to need your magic wand. I have a pipette. You can use a small spoon. You can use one of those syringes that we have for the medicine at home. And we're going to collect some water into it. And then I'm going to squirt the water onto the crystals. Watch what happens. So here we go. Got my wand and I'm going to go glacius. Some more water and glacius, and it's starting to swell in my hand, and I start to have something that looks a bit like a snowball. So we can now have snowball fights throughout the year. Look at this here. Now I've got a small amount there. Can I form that into a ball? I can. Now, what happens when we have a whole load of the powder and we put lots of water in. So we try that, and then we're going to make a snowman. Here we go. Let's have a countdown. 3, 2, 1. Wow. And look, it's like magic. It's all fluffed up. There we go. And we then have some snow. Wow, I love that. So I'm going to make some room on my table now. And with a little bit of camera magic, we're going to have everything that we need for our snowman. 3, 2, 1, back again. Right, so I've got my snow. Oh, look at this. That's the body of my snowman. Okay, there we go. Oh, it's nice and glistening. And then I'm going to get a little hat. And before I put the hat on, I think we're going to need a little scarf as well. So there's our scarf. He's going to need a nose. There's his nose. We'll give him some eyes. And then, voila. Using science magic, we have created a lovely ice cream. We've made snow, and we've also made a little snowman. Oh, thank you. Until the next time, bye.